In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create this particle shield impact animation in 8 minutes. I'll hide the meshes, and show you how they were made from the beginning. Let's create a cube, S, to scale, and, S, and, X, to scale on the, X, axis. I'll use an emission shader to create a glowing material. Please use EV with bloom. We need a plane. We'll use the plane as a particle emitter. I'll use a dark material for the emitter. Let's add particles that are 250 frames long. The default settings produce particles like this, and we need to change that. The glowing cubes are dropping instead of the spheres, but we need them to shoot out instead. Let's rotate the emitter. Time to change the gravity to 0. Select the original glowing cube, press Tab to go to edit mode, and R to rotate it like this. Let's increase the velocity. Let's create a cube to test the particles further. By default, the particles will pass through any objects, unless they have the collision physics equipped. Let's add the collision physics. The lights traveling in different directions like this make a good-looking animation as well. This one as well. Since we're using a value of 0 for the gravity, the particles are returning right back to their starting position. Tab to go to edit mode. Right-click and type S to subdivide the mesh like this. Maybe 50 is too much. Let's try 25 instead. We need to randomize the selected vertices. Press Tab to finalize the mesh. This makes a good space traveling animation as well. Let's create a new cube and create a shield mesh. In edit mode, Ctrl R to add a loop cut. I'll select the vertices in the middle and move them forward on the X axis. In edit mode, type 2 to edge select. Let's select the top and the bottom edges and type S and Z to scale them apart on the Z axis. In edit mode, type 3 to face select. Let's shift select the front faces. If we type I as in India, we can extrude inward. But as we can see, the shape doesn't look even. In object mode, press Ctrl A to set reset all transforms. That looks much better. Let's type E to extrude inward. Right click and type S to subdivide the selected faces. Let's randomize them. I'll add an emission shader. In edit mode, press Ctrl I to invert the selection. I'll apply a metallic material. Once we add the collision physics to the shield mesh, then we're done. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.